All right, we are pleased to be joined by Trailblazers assistant coach David Vanterpool. He is joining us via phone from Charlotte, North Carolina. Coach, thanks for spending time with us. How are you tonight?
I'm good. Thanks for having me.
You got it. Hey, when you get a day off on the road, what are the type of things you like to do? You guys, a rare day off on the road today, and get to mess around in Charlotte at all?
Well, it's not all the way a day off. We had a few of the guys come in to work out, get some shots up, and do a few things on the court. So, you know, it's not always a complete day off, but you get a chance to, I guess, enjoy a part of the day.
Well, some guys go out to movies, you know, they go out to one of their favorite eateries or whatever. So I know that's what Wheels does, at least, right? Wheels gets a lot.
yeah, probably. But, what's interesting is I'm actually walking into a basketball game right now.
So, oh, nice.
UNC Charlotte playing University of Miami. So kind of just going in and check out the game and So yeah, I guess that's how I relax.
Yeah, so Coach, that begs the obvious question, basketball junkie, day off on the road. Who's playing in my environment? Are you that guy?
I mean, you know what? I don't know. I guess I can't get away from it no matter how hard I try.
Well, it is the game we play. It's all about winning games, and Portland right now has reeled off 8 wins in a row. But there has been a trend, if you heard Michael and I just talking about it, of digging an early hole in some of these games. What have you made of this, Coach?
Well, I mean, it's something that obviously we'd like to rectify and do better at. The number one thing ultimately is the goal, and that's to win the game. And, you know, if you can learn an expensive lesson inexpensively, basically you don't have to pay for it and still learn the lesson, and you come out on the better end of the stick. So we really have to learn that lesson immediately and do better at the beginning of the game.
Coach, speaking of that, oftentimes teams script offense at the beginning of the game. There's something you want to establish. You want to see how they're going to play L.A. Can you talk a little bit about what you guys try to establish early in the game? And really what I'm getting at is, do you script defense? Are there some things you want to do defensively at the start of the game?
Well, defensively, I mean, we try to stay as true to who we are as possible. And we consistently want to keep teams out of the paint. We want to keep them off of open threes and force them into mid-range jump shots. So, I mean, that's the formula as it is. And we basically stick to that for the most part. Obviously, we have to do some things a little different depending on the circumstances with the opponent and some strengths that they may have as well as some weaknesses. But as basic as it goes, I mean, we stay as true to who we are as possible.
Coach, Damian has been on fire as of late, leads the NBA with 42 three-pointers made. Right now that's 7 better than Steph Curry, who is in second place, and connecting on 46% of those tries. I know, and you know, that Damian knows he can do better, correct? And those are great numbers.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, he's definitely not happy or satisfied with that. I'm not sure if he knows those numbers, if he knows that he has been had that much success, I guess, from the three-point line, if you want to put it that way. But he definitely feels like he can do better. He feels like he's missed some shots that he would normally make, missed some open shots, and you know he's gonna continue to work at it to get better.
I know it's probably water under the bridge right now, but you know, just to get your reaction to it, that cheap shot by Mike Dunleavy Jr. the other night. You know, it's one of those moments that, you know, the team really does come together. You saw Damian come to his defense Wesley come to Dame's defense, and the whole team just kind of rallied around him. And much like the year before from that game down at Golden State, that could, you know, we could look back on this and say that was another one of those turning points.
Well, obviously it was something that I wish didn't happen. I'm not even sure what type of play was trying to be made. I guess he was trying to foul him, but you know, he definitely wasn't a play on the ball, but my mother always told me if you can't say something nice about a situation, don't say anything. So I'll just leave it at that.
Hey, well, I'll weigh in because my mom told me that too, but I can take more liberty. I'm going to tell you, Coach, what I felt when that occurred. It was a sign of respect for you guys as one of the elite teams in the league that created a level of frustration that boiled over in that moment. And I didn't want to read too much into it. I'm not trying to draw you into a conversation about it, but I thought it was significant from that standpoint that the team is playing well and the Blazers are and need to be respected as one of the elite teams in the league right now.
Well, I actually really agree with the comment that you made, and without going in too deeply, you know, frustration sometimes sets in and people react to it differently. And hopefully we will continue to react in a positive manner to our frustration and take it out the right way on the court.
Trailblazers assistant coach David Vanterpool joining us from Charlotte. He's getting ready to go into a basketball game, so we won't keep you for just a couple
minutes. Now, I just got to ask you one more quick question. one more quick question, Coach, though, because the flip side of that coin, the defense has been solid this year and it's been improved, and you can tell it's a focal point. But Philadelphia went 70 points in the paint, and they shot 50%, and the first half looked like a summer league game. I mean, we threw the ball, the Blazers threw the ball all over the place, and all of a sudden it became a game where the ball bounced all over the place. And I thought that said something about the Blazers being able to refocus in the second half and get back to your principles.
Well, ultimately, everybody here plays in the NBA, and you're going to have people that are able to basically base you into their style of play at times. And, you know, at times you have to kind of figure out things and have a chance to step back, realize what you need to be doing, try to focus and concentrate a little bit more. So, you know, it's not ever going to be an easy game. There's no such thing in this league as an easy game. It doesn't matter who the opponent is. These guys all come out, they all have pride, and they're all going to play hard, and they're going to make it difficult for you. That same Sixers team that hasn't won a game, lost to Chicago, I think, by three. Mm-hmm. They lost another game by one to a formidable opponent.
Houston.
Houston, exactly. And they've been in situations where they have easily won a game here or there if the ball bounced a different way. So we can't discount that. And, I mean, I think it's easy to jump on. You know, jump on the side of, you know, they're not an NBA team and Kentucky can beat them and all that other type of stuff. But, I mean, a real basketball person will look at the real reality of the situation and see that they could have won a couple games here or there. So you can't take anything for granted in this league.
Coach, one last question, and then we'll cut you loose. C.J. McCollum going to miss the next month. Can you just speak about his development? Because he looked like he was really rounding into form in year two.
Yeah, CJ's been doing a lot of work off the court, studying film, doing things that where he worked on not just his shot and his offense, but really his defense. And I think that's the biggest place where he's made a progression is defensively, real understanding how to use angles, how to stay in front of guys. And I know he and I have been working continuously with that stuff and just kind of helping him to try to recognize those things. He has the offensive savvy and the ability to obviously score, but some of the other things to help his game become a little more well-rounded, I think, has helped him as well as offensively because it allows him to be a little bit more comfortable just in a general sense on the court. So his development has been great. You know, unfortunately, he did get injured, but it'll just give him more time to study and get ready for the major test.
He's smart enough. He'll be back before you know it, and we wish him, obviously, a speedy recovery. Coach, thank you for the time. Let's make it 9 in a row tomorrow in Charlotte.
Absolutely. Thanks.
Appreciate it. Enjoy that game. All right.
All right.
Assistant coach David Vanterpool joining us from Charlotte tonight.